Hello everyone, welcome to this session. So today we are going to talk about module 1, which is introduction to cybercrime. In this session you are going to learn various terminology, like the definition of cybercrime, what is cyber warfare, what is cyber squatting, what is cyber terrorism, and all these things. So let's see this. So here on the screen you can see the definition of cybercrime. So it is defined as a crime conducted in which a computer was directly and significantly instrumental. So it's a very simple definition. So if you are using a computer to do bad things, that is a cybercrime. This is a very old definition, but nowadays the crimes are being committed without using computers. For example, if you consider IoT devices like CC cameras, smart ACs, smart fridges, and all these things, hackers or attackers, they are using these devices to conduct their attacks on their targets. So in this kind of IoT attack scenarios, there is no computer. Okay, but even though it can be treated as cyber crime. So the definition is changing. And these are four other definitions for cyber crime. You can pause the video and go through these four definitions. And now different types of cybercrimes. They are classified into two types. One is technocrime and another one is techno vandalism. So here you have the two types, technocrime and techno vandalism. So the gist is very simple. Technocrime is targeted on a particular individual or a particular organization. So you have already someone in the mind that you want to destroy and you perform the attack. But techno vandalism, here we don't have any target in our mind. We just take something and perform attacks randomly. Okay, we don't care about whom you are performing the attacks and who is going to be affected, like kind of sadism. Okay. And then another terminology, cyber terrorism. Okay, so there is a very lengthy definition here. So the gist of this definition is, if you are doing bad things, that is conducting crimes with terrorist intent, okay, that is called cyber terrorism. So if you are trying to damage something, if you are trying to access national secrets to perform terror attacks, that is treated as cyber terrorism. Okay, right. And cyber terrorism, the concept or the term was coined by a person called Barry Collins. So he is a senior research fellow at Institute for Security and Intelligence. And next piece of terminology is cyberspace. So it's like a virtual world. So the definition is cyberspace. It is a network of computer networks or devices that uses some kind of protocol suite. Here in this case, it is mentioned as TCP/IP that facilitates communication and exchange of data. Okay, so I think all of you have watched the movie series Matrix. Okay, so the people go through telephone lines into a virtual world. So you can imagine cyberspace like that. And the cyberspace term was coined by the person William Gibson. So he's a science fiction writer, and in his sci-fi novel Neomancer, he has mentioned this term cyberspace. Okay, then another terminology, cyber squatting. So what is cyber squatting means? You are buying domains which look very similar to existing domains. For example, consider the website Amazon. So I am going to buy a website called amazona.com. Okay, so there is only one character difference. After Amazon there is another letter a.com. okay, so you can see here why cyber squatting is done. It is done with the intent to sell those domain names to the original website others, I mean owners, domain owners. So I would like to tell something here. This thing can be used for committing crimes. For example, as I already told you, we have amazona.com website, right? So I will just place some products and I will give a login form, and I will advertise my website amazona.com. So people will come to the website, click on some products, they think that it is amazon.com, but in fact it is another website, amazona.com. okay, so they will pay for the products and they will be waiting for the products. But what will the person who is owning amazona.com do? He will just take the money and will never send the products. So cyber squatting can be used for like that also. And another terminology, cyber warfare. So you can see the flags of two nations here. So I think you can identify what are those nations. So the definition is like this. It is called, termed as information warriors unleashing vicious attacks against opponents, computer networks, wreaking havoc and paralyzing nations. So what is the difference between cyber warfare or cyber terrorism means? In cyber warfare, the nations themselves will recruit people to perform attacks on other nations. Okay, that is the difference that you will see in cyber warfare and cyber terrorism. Whereas cyber terrorism, they are individual groups of people who want to damage. Okay, but cyber warfare, the people are within the government itself, they are supported by the country. And finally, we will end this session by looking at some differences between real world crimes and cyber crimes. So real world crimes means the crimes that are performed in the real world outside without using any computers, and obviously cyber crimes means the crimes that are committed using computers and networks. So in real world crimes, it is difficult to learn. Why? Because we need to have the hardware, like I need a knife, I need a gun and all these things, I have to purchase those things. But here it is very easy in cyber to commit cyber crime. Why? If you have a mobile or a computer, you can plug into internet and do whatever you want. And again, second difference, committing real world crimes requires more resources and planning. Yes, for example, if you want to do a bank heist, you need a group of people, you have to gather them, maybe you have to give some training to them, you have to plan the heist properly, and then you have to commit the crime. But here it doesn't require more amount of resources or even planning. You just take some software or you write your own code to perform the attack, and it's easy when compared to real world crimes. And next difference, they require, real world crimes require physical presence of attacker. So in the bank heist example, actually the person who wants to rob the bank has to go to the bank. But here in cyber crime, it is not required. Okay, so physical presence of the attacker is not required. You can just sit at the computer and you can even pull out the money from another person's account who is across the globe somewhere else. Okay, so it's easy. And real world crimes are clearly legal and punishable. So for every crime there is some section in the law. So according to this section, that person who performs the real world crime will be punished. But here, when you come to cyber crimes, there are sections, but they are not clear. Okay, they are fuzzy kind of thing. So that's it. These are the differences between real world crimes and cyber crimes. Thank you.